Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to install SQL Server and its related components, because those who are following my channel, they desperately need these things. Like, they need to go for installing SQL Server, and once they start working on SSIS and SSAS, they don't know how to install it. So together, in a single video, I will demonstrate how to install SQL Server along with SSIS, SSAS. Let's begin. So what are the things we need while we are working in analytics? It's like, you need SQL Server DBMS, that is, it will install the DBMS, an analysis service for creating cubes, and SQL Server integration service for ETL packages. And then we need data tools to build SIS and analysis service packages, then SQL Server Management Studio. All these things together in a single video, I will demonstrate here. Let's begin. Go to Google and say SQL Server Developer Edition. Okay, earlier one of the video in SSAS installation, I mentioned Evolution Edition, that will expire in 6 months. So this developer edition is stay for long. That is why one of the subscribers has recommended. So I thought that is a good practice to go for it. So here you need to choose the SQL Server on-premise. It is not Azure, it is not Edge. So this is the free trial, or download a specialized edition, right? So don't do that. You need to go for this, download a free specialized edition, that is developer. Okay, so this will contain the entire enterprise version of it, but it is advised in the Microsoft portal, like, it is meant for single developer, right? It is personal use or not non-production environment. You can use this version. So click on download. As soon as you click on it, it will download only the exe file, and this will prompt you the actual downloads. So once you click on it, double click on it, let's click on S. So it will check whatever things require for us. Let's go for basic or customized installation. So select basic installation type to install SQL Database Engine features default configuration. But we need some customization. We need to ensure certain things. We need to install it. So let's go for custom and let this package download it. So you can see it was 1000 MB. So almost 1 GB. Let's wait for it. So it is downloaded. I think it's checking some consistency check or integrity checks, and it is extracting the setup. Once it downloaded, then it will once it unzip, then it will prompt us for relation steps. Let's wait for it. Okay, now we have a screen here where we need to install SQL Server, right? So go to installation. Here is the catch. Whatever I explained you here, what are the things we need to install? It is not a one single click you can do. The first three things, the integration, SQL Server, everything, you can install it using this new standalone installation, add features, okay? Then for installing Management Studio and data tools, we need to repeat or execute this the setup files once again. Okay, that is what we need to do it. So let's do first the installation, and then we will come and install other things after that. So this is developer edition, doesn't require any licensing. You just accept whatever you want, and once you downloaded it and installed the things, I mean, this is like checking up some of the files, or it's trying to extract some of the setup files. So install setup files. Once it is done, this is what the important step, the future selection, where we will select the SQL Server, SSAS, SSIS, all other things. Let's wait for that step to come. So it disappeared, the new window is appearing. Let's wait for it. There you go. There was firewall warning, that is absolutely fine with me. Now here is the important thing. Let me zoom in and we can check together. So this is the important check you need to do, that is database engine service. You see, even R Python machine learning extension also there in the latest 2019 version. So that is not our intention right now. So, and then you need to choose the analysis service, database engine analysis service. This will install the SSAS. Then there comes the shared features, right? So integration services is a shared feature, so you need to click on that as well. So this three are the things you need to check, that is database engine, then analysis service, then integration services. So these three things that will install all these three. Okay, ensure that you are checking it, then click on next. And you can give a proper name over here. Already we have analysis service, so this is for giving some instance name. Let me put Naga 2019, okay, something like that. That will give us some decent naming. Naga SQL, maybe. This is my server name, I mean the instance name, or the server name we can call it as. Okay, this will install Naga SQL 2019, so we can have which version it is, because I have multiple versions in my system. So I'm renaming the new server as Naga SQL 2019. Now here it will create all this service account. You say yes here, otherwise you can provide some other user. This is to configure what kind of authentication you need. I will go for Windows. I'm not going for SQL Server for simplicity. And in case of actual organization, you will go for SQL Server, or based on your organization rules. So this is the important factor, analyst service. Here you can choose multi-dimensional tabular. This is what Microsoft recommending. So choose, ensure you have a tabular model. This will install you the SSAS tabular instance. Then that's it. So once you choose all other things, then click on install. It will take a couple of minutes, and once it is done, we can check and other features. We can try to install other features. See, now we are done with the installation. Whatever we want, we install database engine, we install analyst services and integration services. So the first three part are done. So once it is done, you can close it. Then you can go to the main installation. then we can step on to the next data tools. So for this, click on this install data tools. I already got installed, so this is prompting you to install it. Okay, so this is the latest version, and you, if you want, you can download the older version changes for install SSDT with Visual Studio, or you can go for standalone installation, right? To install Visual Studio installation storage, I mean install SSDT with Visual Studio 2017. So along with 2017, you can go with that. So these are the steps you can follow it once you download it, right? So this is navigation pane. So once we came here, this is installed. Now we need to install these two. It is navigating to some other page. So follow this. So data tools, it will prompt you here, then download the appropriate version. So if you are familiar with the latest version, you can go for it, or you can go for the or earlier version. The, if you already have Visual Studio, there is a way to install. That is what it is explained here. Go to these things and choose this option, then do the install with downloading, something like that. So that is what it is prompting you the steps. Okay. So here it says like to install integration repo project, run the SSDT standalone installer. So this is like whatever you have seen till this, it's like you already have a Visual Studio in your system and you can add on from that. Or you do not have Visual Studio, you can follow this instruction like install integration reporting services as a standalone. So click on this, this will download, this will prompt you to download this latest version. Download it, then double click on it, it will prompt you the list of steps available. So you can see the steps over here. It will prompt you to select all the options, whatever you want. If you do not want reporting services, it is SSRS, you can uncheck it. If you want to practice it, check this one and install it, you can practice it later. So once you are done with SQL Server data tools as well, then move back to your installation step, then click on the SQL Server management schedule. Again, it will prompt you to download another software. Just download the latest version, then install it. It is just a double click that people are familiar with Microsoft, how they can install. Once you download and double click on the exe file, it will install it. So once you these four tools or all the tools are installed, then you are ready to go. You can check by connecting a database engine, clicking on dot, or you provide your server name, and then you can ensure you can start working on it. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.